It was hard to do what was requested. But as I did what I had to do, a small feeling of uneasiness tingled inside me. When I sat back down, Link had already finished and placed his cup down in front of him. I then placed mine down in front of me and waited for what to do next. The head monk said a few words, then we were told to exchange the cups and drink from them. Link went first, and I watched as his face twisted slightly as he drank from the cup. Then I took my cup, slowly lifted it to my lips, and crinkled my nose as I drank from it. A sour taste was left behind after I finished. Next, we were told to close our eyes and hold hands. The monk began to chant in an unknown tongue. As he chanted, I felt a presence around me, something like a spirit, but I was not quite sure. A warm feeling filled inside me, like being next to a fire. And I felt at peace, felt a calm, then I could feel Link again. Felt his body against mine, even though our hands were the only things touching. The feeling made me feel happy inside, made me feel closer to him. I hoped that the feeling would never end. I opened my eyes, and the monk had stopped chanting, and he then explained that there were four more separate bonding rituals, each to bond us together in every aspect of our being. They were mentally, spiritually, physically, and sexually. Completing each would bond us together in an unbreakable bond. When we were ready, we nodded and were told what the first ritual was. The mental bonding. After the rules were explained, we took each other's hands and held them. When the head monk began to chant, we closed our eyes. I began to feel the warm feeling inside me again. This time it was more intense. Then my mind was cleared of all thoughts, and I was left in total emptiness, like being in a void. There was nothing but quiet. Then the silence was broken by a distant voice. As the voice came closer, I could tell that it was Link's. Link was inside my mind! Calling out to me. I reached for him, called out to him, tried to find him. As he called to me again, his voice ringed through my mind. His voice vibrated through my body, inside my bones. His voice made me feel warm, made me feel secure. I did not feel alone.
You're not alone!
He was there with me. Hearing his voice inside my mind made me feel closer to him. I felt as if our minds were connected. I felt as if we're one. As I sat for him, his voice seemed like a flame. I felt its warmth, then saw its light. I reached for it, called to it, watched as the flame danced. Link's voice ran inside it. I moved inside the emptiness. Tried to reach for the flame, tried to reach for Link, but no matter how hard I tried, I could not reach it. Then the flame flicked out, and Link's voice became distant again, until all there was but silence.
Within the sound of silence, in restless dreams,
the void closed around me, and I came back. I opened my eyes and looked at Link. He was just as wide-eyed as me. Then I smiled at him before turning attention to the monk. He looked at us and told us the mental bonding was complete.
Embed pea brush.
The physical bonding. The head monk told us the rules for the physical bonding. First, we had to put our wrists together and hold them up together and in front of us. Then two monks came with rope and tied our wrists together. A bowl with a white smoke rising from it was put down in front of us. We were told to inch closer to the bowl, and to close our eyes again. The void opened up inside me again, and the warm feeling ran through my bones. I felt Link again, inside my mind and inside my body. I heard his voice calling, felt his body against mine, felt his heart beating. So warm, so calming. I reached for him, tried to touch him. Then the void was shattered when I heard Link scream! I twisted in pain as he screamed inside my mind! My mind felt like it was on fire! The body felt like hot needles were being poked in! As Link twisted in pain, I felt everything he was feeling. He screamed for me to help, but I was helpless. My body felt his heart beating faster, felt him twist in pain. I screamed as his voice ringed loudly through my mind. My head felt like it was being crushed as the intense pain raged through me. I wanted it all to end. Wanted the pain to go away. Since of the connection that was bonding us together, all pain that one feels, the other feels the same at the same time. As the pain intensified, my heart began to beat faster, my pulse raced, and my body twisted and screamed as the shattering screams in pure pain raged through my every vein. Then I opened my eyes and stared at Link with unblinking eyes as I watched him twisting in pain, as he felt everything I was feeling. My wrists twisted as Link and I moved around. I screamed louder, wanted it all to cease, prayed it would end. Then all of a sudden the void broke and the pain ceased. Then I felt the warm rush through me again. Link's heart slowed its beat and his voice ran softly through my mind. Link touched my soul. Then I felt a calming feeling come over me again, as the flame rose in my mind again. A rose bloomed in my soul. Link's voice called from the flame, and his touch came from the rose. I tried to reach for the flame, tried to touch the rose, but the closer I got, the further away they became. Then the feeling changed. A
pleasurable
feeling started to surround me, and it rushed through my body like a raging river. I felt hot inside. It felt erotic. Felt good. Then I could feel Link's touch. It felt like he was inside me. It felt like our bodies merged. And then the feeling grew stronger, grew more intense, and it became like a sexual feeling. It felt like having sex. I felt a stronger connection with Link. Felt as if we were connected. Felt as if we were one. Felt as if we merged. Then the void shattered around me and I awoke. I blinked in the sunlight and looked at Link. He was wiping the sweat from his brow. We were coming around from our strange experience. But we regained our senses quickly. My wrists hurt from all of the twisting. I moved them around against his to get them comfortable. Then I turned to the head monk. He lowered his hands and clapped. The two monks came and removed the rope from around our wrists and took the bowl away. I rubbed my wrists to soothe the pain. He then placed a hand on my head and one on Link's. After about a minuet, we were told the physical bonding was complete. Embed. Brush.